The Dope Sheet is a Maya tool that works in conjunction with the graph editor that has some really neat features but tends to fly under the radar. Hi, I'm Skitty, and today we're going to go over everything you need to know to get animating in the Dope Sheet. Let's go ahead and open our Dope Sheet. In the Windows tab up at the top, hover over Animation Editors and click Dope Sheet about halfway down. If nothing in your scene was selected when you opened the Dope Sheet, the view will be empty just like with the graph editor. Let's go ahead and select this ball so we have something to look at. What we have now is very similar to the graph editor, except we can't see any transforms. On the left here, we have a list of the controls or objects we have selected, and in our main view, we have all these little blocks that represent our keys over time. The purpose of this is so that we can adjust our animation's timing without having to worry about the values of our keys. This top row of keys highlighted in blue is called your Dope Sheet Summary. This shows you every spot that the selected objects have a key. The subsequent rows show the keys for each object. You can expand these objects as well to show translates and rotates separately, and expand those even further to show the individual transforms. Holding Alt and middle mouse dragging will pan in the Dope Sheet, and Alt plus right mouse dragging will zoom your view in and out. Control plus Alt is our focus control. Control Alt left dragging focuses in, and Control Alt middle drag focuses out. Now that we know how to navigate in the Dope Sheet, let's talk about what we actually use it for. We won't be doing any rotates here, but our W and R hotkeys for move and scale will still come in handy. Pressing W to bring up our move tool, we can middle mouse drag to move our keys. Notice how moving the keys from the summary tab moves all of the keys under it, but moving one of the lower keys moves by itself, creating a new key on the Dope summary. If we left mouse drag to select a bunch of keys and hit R to bring up our scale tool, this lattice will appear around your selection with manipulators in the corners. If we hold left click on one of these, our keys will scale in and out. When we're finished, we can left click anywhere outside of our selection to deselect it. Now let's talk about some of the quick use buttons that we have on the Dope Sheet shelf. Starting on the top left, we have three modes to toggle between. We have Select Keys, which lets us left mouse drag a selection box or select individual keys. Move Keys is the default mode, allowing us to middle mouse drag our keys around. Then there's Insert Keys, which inserts new keys with a middle mouse click. These keys add as breakdown keys though, as indicated by the green lines on the time slider. Breakdown keys act differently than normal keys. If you shift the regular key's timing on either side of the breakdown key, the breakdown will shift frames to try to retain the distance it has between the other keys. If you want to change your inserted breakdown to a regular key, just select it, right-click, hover over Keys, and select Convert to Key. You can also add an in-between frame by right-clicking and going to Keys, Insert In-Between. This is a bit misleading since it's under the Keys menu, but it doesn't actually set a key. Instead, it adds an extra empty frame between your keys. If we right-click to go back to the Keys menu, we have the option to mute the keys. This makes Maya skip over that key without deleting it. You can unmute it again at any time. Back up to the shelf, we have three framing buttons here. Frame everything that is displayed, frame what is in playback, and center your view based on current time. Skipping ahead for a bit, we have a toggle to switch from the Dope Sheet to the graph editor, and also to the tracks editor. There's a couple of buttons on the shelf that we skipped over, and we'll come back to those shortly, but first let's look at some of the options that we have in the drop-down menus. In the Edit menu, we can cut, copy, paste, and delete keys. Snap, just like when we use it in the graph editor or on the timeline, snaps your keys to make sure they are on whole frames. Back in the Edit menu, select Unsnapped is a great way to check if any of your keys land on partial frames, since it selects them. In the Curves menu, we have the ability to turn on pre- and post-infinity cycle, which makes your animation loop infinitely, and we have plenty of other curve manipulation tools that I don't recommend touching because the graph editor also does these functions. In the Dope Sheet, we can't see the curves, so it could be doing terrible things to them and we wouldn't even know. The Tangents menu? Same deal. If you want to manipulate tangents, look at them in the graph editor. In the List menu, we have an option called Hierarchy Below. This is one of the buttons that we skipped on the shelf. If you have any parent-child relationships in your scene, turning this on will show a child's keys on the parent, so you don't have to dig through the hierarchy. Back to the List tab, we have an option called Auto Load, which is on by default. This is how objects show up in the Dope Sheet when you select them in your viewport, and why they disappear when you deselect them. If you turn auto load off, objects will stay in your list even if you deselect them. This is where that other button we skipped on our shelf comes in that used to be grayed out. This button is called load selected, and it's how we add to our list when auto load is off. In lists again, we have a bookmarks tab. So if there's a specific group of controls you'll be editing frequently, you can just set a bookmark to easily jump back to that whenever you need to. And that's about all you need to know to get started with the dope sheet. It's a neat little tool that should be used alongside the graph editor and not exclusively. It's definitely more convenient for adjusting your timing, but where you can't see the curves, it's hard to say what's going on in the background. Leave a comment below if there's something you didn't understand. Like and subscribe if you learned something. Links to socials are in the description, and remember to always use a reference.